to another lesson in English vocabulary level 3. Welcome to lesson 30. In this lesson, like other lessons, we continue learning many new vocabulary in English, and we are going to use this vocabulary to improve our abilities in English language, like speaking and writing and listening. Because here we know the meaning of the vocabulary and we know the usage of the vocabulary, so it's important to us to use these abilities, to use these things in order to improve our ability. Let's begin with the first vocabulary in this lesson, in lesson 30. Here we have cause. The word form of cause is noun. Now we have read the vocabulary cause. Let's read the definition of the vocabulary too, in order to understand the meaning about this vocabulary. And you may have been seen this vocabulary cause. It comes with other vocabulary. You may have been studied this vocabulary in high school or in other levels, cause and effect. But now we focus on this vocabulary cause. Here it says cause is a reason why something, especially something bad, happens. So here it says cause, it is a reason for something else. As I told you in the previous lessons, the flood causes many problems. Yes, causes many bad problems to happen to the people and into the city. Here it says it is a reason, it's a bad reason for something, especially something bad, and happens. So as you see here, it says cigarette is a cause of lung cancer. Of cause of what? Of lung cancer. It means if you keep smoking, if you smoke for a long time, so it will have some bad effects and some bad problems for your lungs or for your health. So there are many things that are cause that can be used for this vocabulary cause. So it means the flood causes the damage of the house and causes the buildings to damage and causes the school to damage. So many things can be caused to something. It means this is a bad reason for something else. The Kurdish meaning of this vocabulary here, it means ho, yahut, hoka. Let me give you another example about this vocabulary. Being lazy causes the students to fail in the course, to fail in the class. So it means if you keep not doing your homework, keep not doing your practices, it causes you to fail in the course. Yes. Let's read some sentence examples about this vocabulary and understand more about the meaning and the usage of the vocabulary. Number one, the police are still trying to establish the cause of the fire. So the fire happened in the house or maybe in a factory. We don't know where the fire is, but here the police are trying to establish the cause, to know the reason why the place caught fire. Number two, here we have global warming. Global warming is the cause for damaging our products. So you know, with the global warming, the temperature of Earth rises, and this high amount of energy, this high amount of heat in our planet Earth, it causes many products in the farmlands, in the river, to damage them. So it means to destroy all the plants and destroy all the animals and in the lands and the farm lands. Number three, eating too much of candy causes the damage of the teeth. So here it means if you eat too much candy, eat too much sweet and candy, it causes to the damage of the teeth. Number four, studying hard is the cause of getting good grades. So here it means if you study very hard for a course or for a quiz or for exam, it causes of getting good grades. So the reason is that you study hard. For what reason you study hard? To get a good grades in the quizzes, in the exams. Here we have more examples of this vocabulary. So try to write your sentence examples about this vocabulary and try to read this vocabulary into the other sentences that you like. Number four, sugar is the major cause of tooth decay. So here it means if someone eats too much sugar, so it causes, this is a major cause, this is a main cause of the tooth decay. So your teeth decays and you find out there is no teeth in your mouth. Number six, one common cause of homeless is separation or divorce in the families. So here we have many families, and the family members are separated or they are divorced. So the father and the mother are divorced. So this is a separation of the family. So one cause of homeless, when you don't have home, you don't have home, your children don't have home, they live in other places. So the only cause for homeless is a separation or divorce in the families, in the family members. Number seven, the bomb was designed to cause the maximum amount of damage. So here it means the purpose and the reason that this bomb is designed to damage maximum amount of building, maximum amount of area. So the bomb was designed to cause or to reason the maximum amount of damage. So let's read the practice example about this vocabulary. Number one, global warming is a blank for damaging our products in the lands. A, cause. B, mod. D, environment. C, environment. D, spontaneous. Yes. Let's know what vocabulary is a proper one for the blank, but first let's read the sentence and understand the sentence, and then we're going to pick up the proper vocabulary, the right vocabulary for the blank. So here our issue is what is global warming. So you know that global warming has some bad effects on the planet and on our health as a humans, on different things in our planet Earth. So here it means global warming is a what? For damaging our products in the lands. So you see, you remember that when something is a reason for a bad thing is the result of that reason, so we call that thing cause, right? The whole vocab. So the global warming is a cause for damaging our products in the lands. Our products may be different species of plants. We have many different types of plants like cucumber and tomato and cork. So these are all the products we have in our land. The global warming, the weather is very hot, and by the global warming we have lost all of our products in the lands. So here we say global warming is a major cause for damaging our products in the lands. So here this is cause. Practice number two. One common blank of homeless is separation or divorce in the families. A, why? B, cause. C, effect. D, point. Yes. Again, let's pick up the proper vocabulary for the blank. Here it says one common what? One common major of thing that of homeless is separation or divorce in the families. So there should be something that causes or it's a reason for homeless, that you don't have the home, or the children, the family members, they live in somewhere else, they don't have home. Yes, the major cause, the major reason for don't having home is separation or divorce in the family. So you know the meaning of divorce. You have to remember the meaning of this vocabulary because we have covered this in the previous lessons. So now we say that we should have have one common and one major cause of homeless, that in a situation that you don't have home, it's a separation or divorce in the families. When the father and the mother get divorced, those children they have to go somewhere else, because the father and the mother won't stay anymore in the home, so the children will be homeless, so they don't have any home. So this is a cause. This is a cause for all homeless. Divorce and separation, this is a cause of homeless. So this is a reason. Sometimes the reason is bad. The effect, the result of the reason is bad. Yeah. Welcome to another vocabulary in this lesson. Here we have ambitions. The word form of ambitions is noun. So we have different word forms of this vocabulary. Let's read. Ambitious. Ambitious, this is adjective form of the vocabulary. Ambitiously, this is adverb form of the vocabulary. So it's important to you, when you start to learn a vocabulary, you have to learn its word forms, and you have to know how to read the vocabulary. Also, you have to know how to write the vocabulary. These are the most important things that you have to know about each vocabulary. If you want to know more about the vocabulary, in order to use this vocabulary into your writings and into your speech while you speak with someone else, or maybe with your friend, maybe with your teacher. So you have to know the pronunciation of the vocabulary: ambition, ambitions, ambitious, ambitiously. So these are the different word forms of the vocabulary. So now we have read the vocabulary, let's read the definition of the vocabulary and understand more about the meaning. Number one, this is a definition for ambitions in the noun form: a strong wish to be successful, powerful, rich, etc. So it means you have a hope, you wish to have something, you wish to be successful in a major, in something. Yes, you wish to be a powerful man, you wish to be rich, you wish to have something, you wish to get married soon. So these are the things that you wish to have, that you wish to do. So this is the ambitions. This is a definition for ambitious, adjective form. It means having a strong wish to be successful, or to be powerful, or to be rich. So it means I have some ambitions. What are your ambitions? My ambitions is to be a successful teacher, to be a successful English teacher. Or my ambitions is to get a car for my car, to get a car for my father or for my mother. So these are the strong wishes that you wish to do something or to have something. It's like a hope. Actually, it's different from hope in different parts, but actually, you can say this is a hope. Ambitiously, this is a verb form of this vocabulary. Here it means successfully wish to something or to have it. So it means all of them, they give the same meaning. It means you have a strong wish to do something or to have something. So the most important thing here, you have to know the meaning, you have to know the usage of the vocabulary. When you use ambitions as a noun in a sentence, you have to know how to where to place this vocabulary in the sentence, and where to place the adjective. As we have covered that, we have learned that adjective, this is a description for the noun in the sentence, and adverb, this is a description for the verb of the subject, for the verb of the sentence. The Kurdish meaning of this vocabulary, it means hasti bar bakhogun kasar dakevi. So you have a wish to do something. You have a wish to have something or to do something. For example, you wish to have a car. So this is ambitions, one of your ambitions. Or you ambitiously think about the result of the project. So it means you have some hope of the project. Yes, let's read some sentence example about this vocabulary and understand more about the usage and the meaning of the vocabulary. Number one, after his heart attack, he abandoned his ambition to become a prime minister. So here we have a successful parliamentary. After his heart attack, he abandoned his ambitions to become a prime minister. So he lost that idea to be a prime minister. So he has forgotten everything about his ambitions. Number two, Niyad has already achieved his main ambition in life, to He's wishing to be a rich man in the future. He's wishing to be wealthy in the future, to become wealthy, to have many houses, to have many nice cars, to have many nice girlfriends. So it means Niyad has already achieved his main ambition in life. So he has achieved his ambitions in his life to become wealth. So he became wealth. He became a wealth person. Number three, Karwan is very ambitious for his children, and he wants his children study engineering in the future. So here we have Karwan. Yeah, Karwan has many children, maybe two or three children. So Karwan is very ambitious. When someone is ambitious, he thinks about everything ambitiously. He says, I have many hopes for my children. So my children will be engineers because they are clever. They want to study engineering. When they finish school, they will get a good grade and they will apply for the engineering courses. They apply for the university and they study engineering. So it means when you are ambitious, you think only about the good things, not the bad things. So you say our project will win. So it means you are ambitiously think about the result of the project, the result of the plan. So remember that this is the adjective form of the vocabulary. It's been description for Karwan. So it means Karwan, how is Karwan? Karwan is ambitious. Number four, the government has announced an ambitious program to modernize the railway network. So here the government has announced an ambitious program. So this program is good. So when you see the word ambitions is coming before a program, so you know that this program is good. So this program has will have many good things for people, for us, especially for modernizing the railway network. So let's read more examples about this vocabulary. Please don't get bored when I read these many vocabulary included in the sentence, because they are designed, they are written to you in order to help you understand the meaning and to observe the vocabulary in many different sentences. So try to read books, try to read all the textual magazines, textual essays and paragraphs in order to know more about the vocabulary, because this is the only way to improve your abilities in reading. Number five, the original completion date was over ambitions. So we have had to delay the opening by 6 months. So here this, we have an ambitions to finish our project or finish our plan on time. So they say, we will give you more time to finish your project. We will give you more time to work on your project hard. So it means there are many ambitions. So it was over ambitions. The original completion of date of the plan. Number six, Sari ambitiously works on her project, and she wants to propose her plan next month in Wanga group. So here we have Sally. She ambitiously works. It means she works in hope. So she has many hopes on her project. So she says, my project is very good. She thinks about the good sides of her project. She says, my project is good, and the project will win in the Wanga group. In Wanga group, this is a group. They are helping different people. They are helping all the youth, all the adults who want to be famous and who want to show their abilities in different fields, like in science, in literature, or in medicine, in engineering. So they evaluate your ability in your field that, or in your major that you are studying. So she ambitiously works on her project, and she wants to propose her plan next next month in Wanga Gu. Practice number one. Number one is a strong wish to be successful or powerful or rich, etc. A. Wish. B. Ambitions. C. Accident. D. Aggressive. Yes, let's pick up the proper vocabulary for the blank. So when we say you have a strong wish to be a successful, you have a strong wish to be a celebrity, you have a ambitious, or you have a strong wish to be a powerful man, to be a rich guy. So these are the strong wishes that you wish. This is what? This is ambitions. Yes, you believe in yourself to be successful in that project or to be successful in that course, because you work ambitiously, you think ambitiously about your project, about your course, about your future. So these are ambitions. These are the strong wishes that you have about your life, about your future. You have a strong wish to be what? To be successful. You have a strong wish to be a powerful man, to be a rich guy, to be a rich man, to be a rich woman in the future. So this is ambitions. B is a proper vocabulary for our blank here. Practice number two. Number two, Sally Lang works on her project and she wants to propose her plan next month in Wanga Group. A. Ambitiously. B. Long. C. Ambition. Yes, let's pick up the proper vocabulary for the blank and let's know who's clever, who has picked up the proper vocabulary or the right vocabulary for the blank. But let's first read the sentence and understand the meaning of the sentence and then pick up the proper vocabulary, because reading the sentence for many times or for the, if you don't get it, the meaning of the, don't get the meaning of the sentence in the first time, try to read it in the second time, in the third time, in the fourth time, because reading helps you to get the concept. Here it says we have Sally, and we have read this example in the previous slides, so you have to remember the meaning. Blank, she works on her project and she wants to propose her plan next month in Wanga Group. So I have told you many things about Wanga Group in the previous slide. So I have told you about Sally. Sally works on her project, yes, and she wants to propose her plan next month in Wanga Group. She wants to say, I will be successful, or my project will be the best one in the in other groups. So my project has contained many different things, and so these things are different from the project of other student or other people in the group, in the Wanga Group. So she says, I have some ambitions, but we know that Sally has some wishes to be successful in the Wanga Group. She will be the winner of the group. So Sally works what? So here we have ambitious, we have ambitiously, we have ambition. So we know that Sally has some wishes to be successful in the in the group, in one group, and he will win the prize, and she will win the prize, she will win the reward at the end of the conference. So we know that it's about wish, it's about strong wish. So here we have ambitiously and we have ambition. We have long is not related to the sentence because there is no anything about borrowing money. So these two are our main points. We have to pick up one of them. So you have to see the sentence here. We have the subject and here we have the verb. So what should become after this? We have the noun. Yeah. So there should be ambitiously, because this is the adverb form of the vocabulary. When you plug the ambitiously in the blank, it will describe the verb of the subject, the verb of the sentence. Sally ambitiously works on her project and she wants to propose her plan next week, next month in one girl group. So the proper vocabulary should be ambitiously. It should be the description for the verb. Yeah. Welcome to another vocabulary. In this lesson here we have hope. Hope is been, it has some relations between ambitious. Here the vocabulary is hope. The word form of hope is verb. So also the same pronunciation hope. It can be a verb, it can be a noun. So now we have read the vocabulary and let's read the definition of the vocabulary and understand more about it. So this is the definition for the verb form hope. It says to want something to happen or to be true, and usually have a good reason to think that might happen. So you have a plan. So you have a hope your project or your plan will be successful in future or in very soon. So you have a hope. The definition for the noun form hope. Second one, something good that you want to happen. So you want something good happen in your plan or in your course. Yes. So you say I have a hope to being accepted in American University in Sulaiman. So you say I have some abilities. I have hope to get accepted in that university, or I have hope to get accepted in other foreign countries, like other foreign universities. So it means you have a hope. You want something good happen in the future, especially, or a confidence feeling about what will happen in the future. Or you have a confidence, you have a hope to something good happen in the future, especially about you, especially about your work and about your wishes. So it means you wish to something happen, you hope to something happen. So you say I have hope to be an engineer in the future, but now you are a clever student. Yes, you know many things about physics, you are good at physics, you are good at chemistry, you are good at math. So you are clever and you have a hope to be an engineer in the future. Or you are good in biology, you have a hope to be a medicine, to be a doctor, to be a physician, to be a pharmacist in the future, to be a dentist. So it means you have a hope. The Kurdish meaning of this vocabulary is hope and hiwa khwastan. Hiwa. So as you see from this picture, there's a quote about this picture. It says, never lose hope. Yes, there's always a way. So when you are in trouble, for example, you have a hope to get accepted, to be escape from the problem or from the bad situation that you are in. So you have to have hope. You say there's a solution for my problem. So this you are hoping. So you have a hope to find a solution for your problem. So this lady is leaving the place because this is very drought. Yes, this is like a desert. This is desert, but this plant has been growing in the middle of the desert. So this is a hope. So you have to have a hope every time when you are in a bad situation. Some sentence examples about this vocabulary. Number one, Sally is too lazy and she is always hoping to leave work early. So Sally is lazy. She's not good at doing works and doing hard tasks at her office, and she wants to go home very early. Go home early every morning, and every day she wants to leave her work and go home. Number two, Cardo is hoping to get a loan from his bank to help his mother out of her financial predicament. So here it means Cardo is hoping to get a loan, to get some money from the bank and give the money to her mother, to his mother, in order to get out her mother into financial problem. So it means his mother has some financial problem and he is hoping to get some money from the bank and give the money to her, to his mother, in order to get out her from the financial problem, from the financial issue. Number three, my family hopes to visit us next month. It's a good news, I hope. So here, you are living far away from your family, far away from your parents. You are living in a different city. You hear that your family hopes to visit you next year, or next month, or another time. So it's a good news. You hope your family, they will visit you. They will visit your home, your house. So you have a hope, you wish. They will visit you next year. Number four, young people are growing up in our cities without any hope of finding a job. So it means all the young people, maybe let's say in Kurdistan. Yeah, in Kurdistan, when all the young people, they hope to get a job, and they do this job and they invest some money that will help them to support the family, to support themselves. But actually, this is a hope. But here in Kurdistan, we are under many monetary problems. We have monetary problems. We have political problems with Iraqi government. So now you cannot get a job easily. So there's no hope. There's no hope to get a job very easy. So it means young people are growing up in our cities, maybe in Kurdistan. They have no hope of finding a new job. So without any hope of finding a job. There are more sentence examples about this vocabulary. The situation is now behind or past hope to produce the desired result. Number six, I didn't phone till 4 o'clock in the hope that they had been finished. Number seven, this new car is seen as a great white hope of the industry, or maybe the car is the friend of nature. So this is a hope to avoid the smokes to rise from the skies, or avoid CO2 emission. Eight, doctors gave my mother powerful drugs in the hope that she might be better. So doctors gave my mother a hope. So this is a hope. They gave my mother powerful drugs, powerful medicines, in the hope that my mother get accepted from the sick, from the patient, she might be better in the future. So the drug is a hope. So we hope this drug, this medicine, help my mother in order to be better in the future, to get escape from the sickness. Practice number one, doctors gave my mother powerful drugs and powerful medicines in the what, that she might be better. A, hope. B, ambition. C, addiction. D, climate. Yes, let's pick up the proper vocabulary for the blank, and now which one is the right and which one is the proper one for the blank. But first, let's read the sentence. We have read the sentence in the previous slide. Doctors gave my mother powerful drugs and powerful medicines. Why? In the hope that she may be better. So my mother is sick, and doctors gave my mother hope. They gave my mother powerful drugs and powerful medicines in the hope that my mother might be better. Might be better very soon. So this is a hope. You wish this medicine and these drugs help your mother to be better in the future, to be better very soon. So this is not addiction, this is not a climate. This is actually, it can be ambition. Yeah, is ambition that she might be better. But the hope common use of many things, that you hope to get a car, you hope to get accepted from a famous university, or you hope to have a car, you hope to have thousands of dollars, yes, you hope to be an engineer, you hope to be a medicine. So there you hope to wish be a something, or to wish to do something. So hope A is the proper vocabulary for the plan. Doctors gave my mother powerful drugs in the hope that she might be better.